Now here, you see? It takes all the running you can do to keep in the same place. If you want to get somewhere else, you must run at least as twice as fast as that. Lewis Carroll. The Red Queen hypothesis, developed by Leigh Van Valen, is widely used to explain the process of deleterious coevolution and the advantages of sexual reproduction. Coevolution. Species that exist in the same habitats must evolve at the same rate, influencing each other's evolution. This cycle repeats, resulting in a constant rate of reciprocal evolution or extinction over millions of years. The graph for the Red Queen effect reflects the process of coevolution between species through continuous oscillations. In this example, the red line represents the Red Queen and the blue line represents Alice. Oscillations on the graph show how species must continuously evolve and always catch up to each other when facing competition. Let's say Alice is trying to run or catch up to the Red Queen to try and survive in Wonderland. If the Red Queen is running one way, then Alice must run at the same rate to catch up with her. If they both run at the same rate, in the end they always find each other, no matter which direction they take. However, if Alice stops running and decides to stay in the same place, the Red Queen can outcompete her and send orders to off with her head, and boom, Alice will go extinct. The outcompeting of one species due to more efficient adaptations is what is referred to as the law of extinction. The advantages of sexual reproduction and adaptations and resistance through coevolution. In circumstances where variability is beneficial, sexual reproduction can increase the chances of survival greatly. Let us contrast sexual and asexual reproduction in terms of the chances of survival of caterpillars on a toxic mushroom. In nature, plants can produce natural toxins to kill parasites living on them. If asexually reproducing caterpillars are smoking some hookah atop a mushroom, said mushroom can produce a toxin to deter the caterpillars, and no matter how much these caterpillars reproduce, their offspring will be genetically identical to the parents and will not be able to resist the toxins. However, if the caterpillars were able to sexually reproduce, there would be genetic input from two different individuals with different genetic makeups that, during meiosis, would recombine and result in yet another completely different genotype. Through recombination, a genotype with different responses to various environmental pressures can result, including development of resistance to the mushroom toxin. These resistant offspring would thus survive and carry on the genes to the next generation, allowing the formation of a toxin-resistant caterpillar population who can keep on smoking on the mushroom. This example shows how sexual reproduction contributes to the Red Queen effect. Since sexual reproduction results in a greater ability for adaptation on behalf of the caterpillars, the mushroom can keep on producing toxins, but the caterpillars will continue developing resistance to the toxins at the same rate, resulting in, once again, the coevolution of the two species. Created using Powtoon.